Hey guys, Nardy here. Welcome back to my channel. So here we are. Here are my top 10 things that you can do every day to keep you focused, to keep you on your fitness journey, no matter what your fitness goals are. And these are things that I do. Guys, as a mom of four, oh my god, four, when did that happen? I keep like trying to come to reality. Four just happened just like that. All right, four in the past 2 years. We went from two to four, but here we are. But as a mom who loves to exercise, who exercise is a part of her everyday routine, right? I implement my children with me. I don't let them be my excuse. They are my reason, my purpose, my drive. My motivation. This is my self-care time. When I exercise, this is me taking care of me so I can take care of them. Drink plenty of water. I always have water with me. Water is the elixir of life. No matter what your fitness goal is, drink water. I cannot stress how much to drink. Great. Let's talk about nutrition, right? So it's all about what you eat. You want to do something that you can maintain for a lifestyle. I know sometimes we have goals and we're like, okay, I just gained 30 pounds from having this baby and I want to lose this 30 pounds. Instead of being extreme with it and going to these salad smoothies and detox, just take time, be gentle, you know, learn how to eat, prioritize your meals, plan, prep, do all of that and you will be successful. Right, and you will have long-lasting results because when you do those quick fixes, it is exactly what it is. This is a quick fix. It is not a lifetime thing. Find ways to enjoy your workout. Whatever it is, whatever you like. Sometimes I know we see all these things on the internet and you're trying to find, like, what should I do? You know, you can try out a little bit of everything and see what you actually will stick with. Once you find something that you're going to stick with and that you enjoy, keep it going. Find ways to improve that and to push yourself and to just add variety and change it up. This way, you can go the long haul, right? So if you've been doing Zumba or HIIT for a long time, you know, make this be the year that you try something just to just give your body a little bit of excitement and to at least say, I tried it. And this will also help you if you reach into a plateau and you're trying to figure out how can I break that plateau. It's all about changing up, whether it's changing up what you're eating and focusing on that, making sure you're dialing in your nutrition, but also make sure you're dialing on your exercise. You know, find something that is going to challenge you and push you, but at the same time that you enjoy doing. It is not about eating perfect every single day. You're not going to eat 100% clean 100% of the time, right? So even if you don't eat 100% clean, try to at least go 80% at most. So you want to try that 80-20 diet method and use that to help you achieve your goals. And this way you're being more gentle with yourself and you're still enjoying your little sweets when you want to or whatever that treat is that you like. Prioritize your health and fitness. And that goes, health and fitness goes for everything. Making time to plan out your meals for the week, what you're going to eat, even if you don't cook ahead, but just plan ahead. Say, you know, write it down and say, okay, these are my meals and this is what I'm going to have. It will help you then when it's time to eat and you go in the kitchen, you're like, oh, what am I going to eat today? At least you know. And this way you can also track your macros and you know how you're eating for your goals. Also prioritize your fitness, right? So as a mom of four and working from home, doing my online fitness thing and having four kids, taking care of a whole household, it is a lot of work, right? I feel like I'm doing much more work than I am doing, even aside from the kids, but than what I was doing when I was a cop. I feel like I'm doing way much more. But back then, I still prioritized time for myself, and it's the same thing now. You're gonna, even if it's 10, 15 minutes out of your day, you are going to prioritize that time and say, okay, this is my time, and I'm gonna have my me time as far as taking care of my health, whether it's planning your meals and prepping them, and then also prioritizing your exercise as well. Saying that you don't have enough time to exercise cannot be your excuse anymore, right? You don't have to spend hours in the gym. Whether it's a quick 10 minute here in the morning and 10 minute in the evening, it still adds up. It still works. Do it and get it done. Sleep is so important. Let me tell you something. I know, right? Do baby, sleep. Get as much rest as needed. Even if you can take a little quick 5-10 minute nap on your lunch break when you're at work, or even when you're home at the kid with the kids, getting off of social media a little bit early, put down that Netflix and chill. Let it just be chill. Rest your mind, go to bed early, and making sure you're getting good quality sleep. The saying goes, surround yourself with like-minded individuals. So if your goal is, I want to stay fit and exercise, or get fit and exercise, find a group of people, join a support group, whether it's online, especially now with COVID, but find a community of others that are going to support your vision. Because sometimes it's not those people in your house. It's not the closest people to you that's going to support you. It could be a stranger that's going to see what your goal is and be that motivation for you and that accountability partner. So find someone that's going to be your support. I'll be your support. Join my support group. I have that for you guys. And we are in this together. Stay active outside of the gym, right? A lot of times that we go give our 20 minutes, our 30 minutes, or even that hour in the gym, and then the rest of the day we're just sitting around. Remember, you want your whole it to be a lifestyle thing. So if you live a sedentary life, you want to be moving. So get up and stretch every hour, take the stairs, park further in the parking lot. You just want your whole lifestyle to be active. Get up and walk your dog. Do things that's going to keep you off the couch and keep you moving. Wake up early and get it done. It's one of the best tips that I could tell you. Because a lot of times you will wake up and say, I'm going to work out later. And then later comes and you're either too tired or you just don't have the time because you have other things that you have deadlines to meet and you just can't get it done. And by then you're mentally and physically exhausted. So if you wake up early and get it done, you will stick with your fitness goals and you will feel so much more better in by starting your day with active exercise. It will give you energy throughout the day and you just have that good sense of accomplishment when you're done. You're like, yes, I did it. I'm gonna conquer the day now. And lastly, before you go to bed, brush your teeth, get all that gunk out of there. Grab a cup of water and put it by your bedside. And before you go to bed, brush your teeth, get all the gunk out of there, the taste of the food out of there. Plus, it's good hygiene. Fill up your cup of water, put it by your bedside, and make sure you get rest and ready, repeat. Hey guys, and before you go, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Give this video a thumbs up. Follow me on Instagram if you're not doing so, or on my Facebook. See you next time.